Hi there, I'm Daniel Seberg with Google Developers Live here at I.O. 2013. And I am joined right now by Shalini Agarwal, who is a product manager with Gmail.
Yep.
Gmail, which obviously for a lot of folks has become indispensable on the consumer side. But what we're going to talk about is not just the changes people are going to see in their inbox, but how the team has thought, you know, what can other companies do to really make it more manageable and easier for people to get through all of that information that they get every day. So tell me about some of the announcements that were made here, first of all, at I.O.
Yeah, great. So yesterday, we announced that we were launching four different types of actions in the inbox. And really, the motivation behind it was that users have a lot of email to process. And each email takes a lot of steps, a lot of time to really manage, right? So anything you want to do involves a lot of steps. We really wanted to bring those steps and those actions directly to the top level of the inbox so users can manage their interactions with their services much more quickly, much more easily, and get through the things that they need to do.
And so the idea of these quick action buttons or however we want to describe them, you don't have to open the email. I mean, they're right there. We've been had the chance to test it internally, and I feel like I've only scratched the surface with what you can do with them, but it's right there as a button within the
menu. It's right there. Yeah. The button is right there at the top of the level of the inbox. For certain cases, when you need more information, you can click on it and it opens up a nice overlay with the key information that you need and the key actions, and that's it. It's really quite simple and quite fast for users.
All right, well, let's see it in action.
All right.
You've got a demo here for us.
Yeah, so
we're going to go into your virtual inbox, we should say. This is kind of your email.
It is. Yeah. So the first action that we'll take a look at is RSVPing. So when your friends invite you to events or birthday parties or whatnot, you usually get an email telling you about the invitation. And now with the action in the inbox, you get a button on the right-hand side, this RSVP button right here. And when you click on it, you get the key information. So here I can find out that, okay, it's a taco night. The event was hosted by Google Calendar. And it's on Sunday at 7 p.m. and there's one other person going. If Clarence had entered a location, that would also show up here. So with one click, I open this overlay, and another click, I hit yes. Now he knows I'm going, right? So that's it. Gmail on the back end has sent the information to Calendar. So if you want, we can take a quick look over at Google Calendar.
Yep.
And here it is, taco night. And there it is, yes, I'm going. So. This is Google Calendar, but this could work for any event service. For example, Paperless Post is one of our launch partners, so when we launch this feature, we'll be launching it with them.
And so they would choose to have this added to their email campaign or whatever they were going to do with it. It's something they would build into the email itself when they send it out, essentially.
Yeah, so it's actually very simple. Our goal was to make it extremely easy for developers to do this. So all they have to do is add markup to their emails. We've been working with schema.org to try and get this markup standardized and reviewed by other parties, out there, other email clients, and it's that simple. They add some schema.org markup, tell us about the event, tell us about the action, tell us where to send the response once the user takes it, and that's it.
And the hope, too, obviously, is that there would be increased engagement with people because it's so convenient for them to actually just one click and they're in. Right.
Exactly. When you host a party, you want to know if people are coming. You want people to quickly figure out if they can come and respond. And not just that, when I get invitations to parties, I first want to see the information about the party. Then later on, I might decide if I'm going or not. And then on the day of the party, I'll go back and find the email to get the key details of like what time it is, where it is.
Right.
So we wanted to make all of those steps really, really easy.
That's great. Now you've got a few more things you can show us here, right?
Yeah. So the second type of action is what we call the one-click action, and really is just one button to take a specific action. So in this case, Google Offers has already started marking up their emails with this schema. So when I get the daily email from them, today's happens to be from Michael Stores, which I shop at a lot. I get picture frames done there. So with one click, I can say get offer. And it looks like the demo didn't work. But normally what would happen is when I click the button, I would go over to Google Offers and it would show up right there.
Okay.
But clearly we had a little demo breakdown here.
It could easily be a connectivity issue, which I think it is. I see down on the right.
Oh, there it is.
We've lost the Wi-Fi, so.
Let's try it one more time. Reload here.
Here we go.
Now let's try it again.
Yep.
If I click the button, There
this
it is.
Is
you
promising.
Can see Gmail.
There you go.
Sent the message to Google Offers, and
yep.
I go here. I reload this tab also.
Yep.
And
there it is.
There it is.
Very nice.
One click. Didn't have to open email.
Yep.
Didn't have to leave the inbox.
Yep.
And I can keep going on to the next item. So
that's fantastic.
Yeah.
And then the next one. Now these. So tell me again which ones were announced here. And which ones are coming soon?
Yeah,
sense.
So we announced four.
Okay.
We announced the RSVP that we saw, the one-click button,
yep.
Rate and review,
mm-hmm.
and a go-to action, which is really for complex actions that can't be achieved from the inbox.
Okay.
So for those, you actually need to go off to a site, a deep link, and complete your action. So those were the four that were announced.
Okay, and the rate is the next one the rate one of the rate and
the
review ones
one
you can
the
show
rate
us?
And review,
okay.
Yeah. So. Again, so we're working with Seamless
yep.
as one of our launch partners. And so when you order order through them, you order food from a restaurant,
mm-hmm.
they can send you an email that asks you to rate your experience.
Yep.
And that's important because you want to tell, when you rate your experiences, you get better suggestions, right?
Right.
So
right.
Your experience with that service is better down the road.
Yep.
So with the review action, again, it's similar to RSVP. You get the key information you need, the name of the restaurant, the whoever you ordered through,
yep.
a picture of whether it's a product, here it's food, it could be a product, a movie,
yep.
anything, and you can quickly rate and review right in this little box. So you say, hey, this solid meal, will order again, and that's it. You can see that Gmail is sending the rating to Seamless, and that's it.
Does that get posted anywhere or shared anywhere else? It goes to Seamless.com.
Yeah.
Okay, that's great.
It goes to Seamless.com. So
and
now,
I think that's, from a convenience standpoint, that's awesome. I mean,
yeah.
Sometimes you just are a little reluctant to go into your email and then go to the site and so on. So, for Seamless or any other company, this has obviously got to be a big win because
yeah.
now they're really going to get that kind of people actually responding to these things rather than just deciding not to.
It's kind of amazing. I counted the number of steps it takes to actually do this without
yep.
the button. And it takes 6 steps.
I believe
right?
you. I am not surprised.
And that's if you remember your login information and all that stuff.
Yep, yep. So. It's a deterrent for some people. It just is. Okay.
Yeah.
Now the next one, can we talk about the dial?
Yeah, so this is another, it's the same thing as the one click action that we saw for Google Offers.
Yep.
But the really cool thing, I gotta say, the one click action is my favorite because you can do so many different kinds of things with it. Any type of use case that is just a one-click action can be done. So in this case, it's an email that's actually from Aetna, which is a communication service that's letting me know that I missed a call from Claudio.
Okay.
And so they've enabled this one-click button. So when I dial it, when I click the button, Gmail tells Aetna, okay, the user clicked the button that you added. And what they do on the back end is connect the call between me and Claudio. So the moment I click it, both our phones start ringing.
Gotcha.
So
okay.
I could click it now, but then Claudio's phone might be ringing, and I don't know where he is. He might be in a session
yeah.
somewhere. So.
And then the next one after that, this is not available just yet,
so
right?
The two that are available as of today
yep.
are the go-to, as of yesterday, are this go-to action, which is the sort of the shortcut to a deep link
yep.
on another site, and the button action, which is what we see here with dial and get offer.
Yep, okay.
The ones that are coming soon are RSVP and rate and review.
Okay, so the check-in one
yep.
for flight, that's
yep.
actually available today.
It's available
that's
today.
That's great, that's great. So show me what would be involved here.
So all I would do, so this button's actually not gonna work, but all
sure.
I would
okay.
do is I click, when you receive this email, what do you want to do? You want to check in for your flight, right?
Right?
It's not
right.
that you need to necessarily open the email. It's not that you need to. But if you do decide you want to open the email,
mm-hmm.
what we will have is a beautiful flight card that at the very top, similar to the cards you see in Google Search and Google Now,
right.
at the top of the email, and it'll give you the key information, your connection times, your flight details, the airport information, and also if the flight's on time or not. I can't tell you
uh-huh.
how many times I've gone to the airport to find out that my flight was delayed.
Delayed or canceled altogether.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So here, when you get the check-in email, you'll also get, this beautiful card. It's not launched yet, but it'll be launched soon.
So there is a tie-in then with Now and with Search. We should point out that this is all part of what we're talking about
yeah.
here, right?
Yeah. There definitely is. So for example, if, here we have Oceanic Airlines, but if any airline were to mark up their emails, their confirmation emails or check-in emails, with Schema, that same information will feed many products of Google. So today it'll enable experiences in Gmail, and in Google Now and Google Search and potentially other, you know, experiences across the way, so that users can get the information that they need, that, you know, they're getting from, you know, via email at the best time and place.
Right. This all seems to be tied into the theme of getting the information you need quickly, sort of at a glance, and then moving on to whatever else you need to be doing. Right?
Exactly.
Now tell me, I mean, it feels like there's so much potential for this. What can you tell us kind of what's on the horizon here, where you see this going?
Yeah, I mean, we're really excited about this, and it's really just the beginning. You know, over time, we'll be adding more types of actions. Over time, we'll be adding more types of structured data. So, you know, I talked about the flight card, but also we'll have things for events and hotels. And, you know, we'll be expanding those experiences across Google.
That's great. What's the response been from the merchants and the companies that you've talked to? And maybe you can, I know you mentioned a few of the partners like Seamless, and but if you want to sort of run down maybe a few that have been really actively involved in this.
Yeah, definitely. So we've gotten a lot of response, right? Because at the end of the day, companies and services care about user engagement.
Yeah.
And so they're sending their users emails because they want them to tell them something or do something. And so it's been pretty exciting, you know, as we demo these types of features for partners and the different kinds of use cases they come up with, right? So every partner we have, we start the conversation by saying, tell us about the things that you do with your users and what communications you have with them over email. Because the types of things, you know, it can be anything from, you know, for example, Spotify, right? Mm-hmm. When you subscribe, you know, so I use Spotify and I listen to my brother's playlists. I subscribe to them. So every time he adds music, which is actually pretty often, which is fun, they
you
send
get
me
an email. Right, an email.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And so now I can... Now those emails have a button on the right-hand side that say, listen to the song. And when I click that button, it opens a tab, and if my player is installed, it just starts playing.
That's very clever.
Yeah.
I mean, that's great. And I could see some of these businesses would actually want to do multiple versions of it. I mean, you could get one, like an airline might want a review as well as to remind you of
how was
flight,
your flight,
right? Yeah,
yeah.
Exactly. Because I get those emails too, so it's a bit of both.
Yeah.
You talked a bit about the motivation behind all of this, but maybe you can kind of expand on that a little bit, just in terms of, you know, what people have to deal with in their inbox. I mean, we're all coping with information overload sometimes.
Yeah.
I'm imagining the team really thought hard. I mean, in some ways, this feels really intuitive to me. It almost feels like, oh, this hasn't been there before. Like, it feels like something that just makes sense.
Yeah.
I mean, can you reveal a little bit of the thinking in all of this? I think it's really neat.
Yeah, so it basically boils down to, you know, each email today looks the same, but really it contains all sorts of different types of information.
Right.
And so it should be more tailored. It should be easier to figure out what is that you want to do. It should be more structured, right? Email is extremely unstructured today. So everything you do, you have to figure out, the user has to do the work to figure out what it is that they're being asked to do, what information is in there, and dig for it. And so, you know, open different tabs, and it's like a leaky funnel type of process, right? And it's frustrating. And so oftentimes, you know, you probably know this as a user. I feel it. We see it. A lot of emails go unanswered or unopened.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean the user doesn't want to do those things. It's just too painful.
I think that's an excellent point. I mean, because I think there's best intentions perhaps on both sides.
Exactly.
But not enough of a sort of an easy bridge between the requests and the action to actually do it.
Exactly.
And now if you're just asking somebody to click one button, it doesn't get much simpler than doing that, right?
No.
Anything else you want to mention in terms of, you know, what's coming?
So, you know, I would just say that we definitely want to add more actions, right? We're really excited about this concept of in-place actions. So we're going to work closely with our existing partners, and we want to hear from developers.
I was going to say, I imagine you're going to discover a lot of ways that this could be used that hadn't been thought of before.
Exactly. And we already did. You know, through the process, we've already come up with a few actions that we want to add, right, over the coming months, because they will be good platforms for lots of different cases.
Right.
And help users connect with their services.
And this is all measurable, I mean, by the companies. They can really see the kind of engagement and traction that they're getting from people.
Yeah. I mean, they can track the links, or, you know, they can track when users click on links. They can track when the servlets on their back end are hit, right? So when we send them a response, they know. And so they can easily track that.
That's great. All right, well, Shalini, thank you so much.
Thank you, Daniel.
This has been a great I've learned a lot, and I mean, I use Gmail all the time, but I think this is going to be a fantastic addition to it.
So. We hope so. We're pretty excited.
That's great. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
All right, that's going to do it for now here on Google Developers Live. Stay tuned for lots more content right here.